watching these animals in slow motion is exactly like watching elegant ballet happening in front of you. The way they control their flight in the air, it's very much like a ballerina would do. They really are masters of aerodynamics. My name is Rajat Mittal, and I'm a professor of mechanical engineering at Johns Hopkins University. I want to understand the engineering aspects of these creatures and how they're able to do what they're able to do.
So we're studying spider crickets. They don't actually have wings like most field crickets would. So we're looking at the ways that they move their body and move their limbs to stabilize their posture during a jump up to 75, 80 times their body length. We set the cameras up to take a 10-second long video. We're able to capture them in slow motion very accurately. From there, we pull it into a motion tracking software.
And using this program, we get to recreate the jump in three dimensions. This 3D model basically allows us to determine the different forces acting upon the cricket.
What we found that we didn't expect was that on the first part of the flight, they actually streamlined themselves to maximize the distance that they're going to travel. But once they reached the apex of their trajectory, they immediately transition to kind of a stabilization posture. Now the next thing is to land nicely.
Ultimately, the application would be in really tiny robots, jumping robots over uneven terrain.
You can imagine a situation where there's an earthquake and we want to send in an army of micro robots to search for, you know, injured people, things like that. And you can imagine how complicated that environment would be. A small micro robot kind of inspired by these insects could potentially navigate this kind of terrain in a much more effective manner. It's only when you slow these critters down, then you really start to see the beauty and the intricacy of the way they move.
It's kind of beautiful in a really weird way that you wouldn't really expect to see beauty most of the time.